Hello, darling. What's your name?
Hi, it's Hira.
Hira. Yeah, you're all right, babe. In you go.
Thanks.
In you go. Hello.
Yeah, what's your
name? B. Yeah, that's all good. In you go, babe. How you doing?
Hi.
Are you right? You're Carly, right?
Yes.
And Kenny, I've got your favourite table, guys. Yeah, you just want to go through someone and I'll take you through. Fantastic. Hello,
Angel,
darling. You're right.
Angel.
There you go. Yeah, you're all right, love. Thank you. Angel's in. What's your name, Shree. Fella? Shree. All good. Yeah. Go on. In you go.
Benazir.
Nah, I'm sorry, darling. Your name's not down. You're not coming in. I'm sorry, babe. Feel good. Can you believe it? We're here. And this, my friends, is your ticket to the biggest pre-show party in Elstree Town. And that does include the 2-for-1 offer at Witherspoon's, eh? Look at this beautiful thing. And have we got some VIPs on the guest list tonight? Making her first ever appearance on BBLB since winning Celebrity Big Brother, it's Ulrika Johnson, everybody. Hello, Ulrika. How you doing, darling? Good thing to come to see her. Don't you look fantastic, everybody, eh? Don't you look wonderful? And following our shooting star, we have five wise men who come bearing gifts. It's friends of the show, Lee Kern, Grace Dent, David Snyder, Mike Hawke, and the wonderful Ravi's back. Yes, Ravi. You know you're my favourite, don't you? Yes, Ravi. Plus, it's the first time they've been in the same room together. Hold on to your de-branded lager. It's the ex-housemates, everyone. But first, I've got an Access All Areas pass and I'm going to use it for the last time. It's BBLB News 25.
BBLB News 25. 24-hour news and then some.
So, for the final time, here are the big stories at 6:55pm last night. Housemates sat down for their final farewell dinner party, and it was left to David and Sophie to provide the standout speeches of the evening.
Obviously, thanks, guys, for accepting me coming halfway as a halfway housemate. Thanks for putting up with me being a bit miserable and quiet when I had no to do. Just thank you, guys, because without you guys, you know, accepting me, I would have been miserable.
I'd just like to say that I'm glad that I'm with all the people that I'm with in the final, and if I had to pick anyone to be in the final with, I'd pick you four.
Oh.
I'm not really joking.
What was that? Sophie's with her final four finalists. Just rip Chrissy's heart out and stamp on it, why don't you, Sophie? What do you say to that, Chrissy? Huh? Can't say anything, all right? He's keeping it zipped now. Got him into trouble last time he ran his mouth off. Next up, after these speeches, the dinner party continued with much merriment. That was until they were hit with an unexpected Jacko number. Now, I'm not sure who was Jacko, but Charlie was definitely Bubbles. And finally, things are much calmer today. So at 12:04pm, Big Brother set the remaining housemates the task of writing a Twitter message to their fans on the outside world. Has anyone been Twittering with them today?
Yeah.
Of course you have. David went first.
David?
Yes.
Please slowly read your tweet to Big Brother.
Like my first tweet is, it says, David is very happy to be in the Big Brother house. Feeling nervous about tonight, but is so glad. Wait on, is yeah, so glad to still be here.
Beautifully read. Now, I've got one of the replies from David's Twittering, and it's from his actual local Chinese takeaway. It says, oh dear, David is a walking, talking fortune cookie. How about that? That's it for BBLB News 25, everybody.
BBLB News 25, 24 hour news and then some.
Now, my first guest is Sweden's greatest export, but she's certainly no flat packet celebrity Big Brother winner, Ulrika Johnson, everybody! So we could sit down.
Oh, okay.
So I was just sitting down slowly. It's all right. We could stand up again. Whatever you want to do it. Should we remind ourselves of Ulrika winning? Yeah. Look at that. Hey, look, she come out looking very nice. Got a funny coat on. Little bag.
My little bag.
Yes. Oh. You looked kind of shocked when you got the announcement that it was you. Did you not think you were going to win?
No, not at all. And we had some preparation from Big Brother before we went out, saying, you know, when. Whoever is the winner, there'll be fireworks, and I was like, blah blah blah, yeah, whatever. I wasn't listening to that.
You.
No, I wasn't listening to that. So it was a bit of a kind of surprise.
They all say that. Have you?
It's a game plan.
Yeah, it's a game plan. It's a game plan. Have you kept in touch with any of the housemates?
Tina Malone. I'm in touch with her.
Tina then.
And Mutya.
Tina and Mutya.
I guess. Yeah, the girls. I think for the most part, apart from Latoya, mad woman.
Really?
Yeah.
Right, you don't talk to Latoya?
No.
Right,
no need to.
Right, OK, it's a shame. Now, you seemed kind of throughout your time that you regretted being in the house a little bit. Have you got any sympathy for Sia Vash, who for the last couple of days has been moaning on about how he wanted to get out?
No, absolutely not. And in fact, he doesn't even deserve to be in there now, having seen Lisa go, who deserved to stay.
Oh, how about that?
So, to have somebody get in the final and say, oh, I'm thinking of walking and wasting that place, could have been
out
by something.
Do you know what I think it might be? I'm just going to put this out there for everybody. It was David's birthday. He was getting all the attention.
So
he wanted a bit of airtime right at the end. And he thought,
incredibly manipulative.
Yeah.
And taking all the attention away from David when they were going to do his cake and everything, which...
He's not daft, old Sivas.
No.
And now, what does it feel like once you have got that nod from Davina and it is you and you're sitting in the house and you're all alone, you've been in there for what, whole 3 weeks, you've been in there.
A whole three weeks.
You're thinking to yourself, wow, what's going on in your mind?
Well, the weirdest thing was that I kind of forgot that they were still filming me, so I was kind of walking around. I felt my biggest kind of thing is claustrophobia and being sort of locked in a place, so I actually felt more claustrophobic when everybody had left because I was quite scared. I was on my own, so I was just pacing the house the whole time.
Really?
Just waiting
to get out of it. Right.
And so it was quite kind of... It was just bewildering. It was just bizarre. It was like... A dream.
A bit of a weird dream, yeah.
Yeah,
I bet, quite
weird
surreal.
Dream.
And so, what about this series? You've been watching a lot of it?
I have. I watched it a bit at the beginning, but I don't watch too intensely at the beginning because there seem to be so many housemates and they need a bit of time to settle down. And then I was abroad for 4 weeks this summer, so I sort of missed that.
Yeah.
That was awful.
Yeah, yeah.
But then I've been watching it like obsessively every night.
It's going to happen.
I'm so pleased it's over tonight, so I can go to bed a bit earlier.
What's your favourite bit of the show from this summer?
Well, I think I have to say the aliens episode when Lisa and David went out because it's sort of it was
landmark. It's Big Brother landmark.
It was so
history.
Unique.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was just fantastic. And it was so, Big Brother is so clever coming up with some fantastic things
he
and
is.
Ideas.
Should we have a little reminder of the aliens going out of the house? Have a look at this.
Lisa, David, you will be required to boldly go where no housemate has gone before.
Where's that, Big Brother?
Outside of the Big Brother house.
Oh, Lisa, watch your head. Lisa! Lisa! This is the best day of my life.
Welcome back to the Big Brother house.
Hey!
How was your mission?
I was bloody brilliant!
David's laugh's pretty hilarious at the best of times, but when he was coming out of that alien outfit, it just sounds incredible, doesn't it?
It was made for him, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it's just beautiful. He needs
perfect.
To take that with him.
What was your favourite moment from your time in the house?
Oh, gosh, that's a tricky one. But I think probably the tasks. I mean, in general, all the tasks were fabulous.
Okay,
because,
that.
A, they gave us something to do, but they were so clever. Being electrocuted was quite funny.
It's good fun, that one.
And doing our choreography, which I wasn't able to take part in. I guess singing with Vern, which was... quite a nightmare, but it was fun.
Have you watched anything back?
No, I was handed all the stuff.
Well, no, you haven't even seen you and Vern doing Endless Love together?
Not even 10 seconds of,
really?
Of it.
It's a beautiful thing, isn't it, everybody? You really should watch it back.
No, I really shouldn't.
Right, OK. And now the prize fund, I think we're saying it's £71,320, everybody. They got it back up. That is, if Sia Vash stays in the outfit. It's a little bit lower than they were expecting with 100 grand.
Yeah,
Do you think they'll be disappointed?
I think it's a bit of a shame, actually. Lisa and David came back off after their day out. Everybody had been really naughty. Suddenly there was no prize fund. Nobody wants to give out that they're upset about it, because
yeah, they're all
uncool.
Playing it very cool, aren't
but
they?
Actually, you
wasn't
know,
in there for the money.
No, but it's you know, well, of course, and yeah, that's part of it. So it's a bit of I would, you know, if I was in there now and somebody had done that, I would think I would probably be disappointed.
A little bit disappointed. Who would you like to win, Ulrika?
Without a shadow of a doubt, David.
Really? Yeah. Why, so what is it about, apart from the funny laugh and the alien outfit, what is it about him that you love?
I'm even wearing my Vivian Westwood ring, and I'm hoping to wish him a bit of luck tonight. I think he's been the most consistent. I think he is what he is, and he doesn't pretend to be anything else. He's not manipulative. He's not got a game plan. He seems very, yeah.
All right, Ulrika, well, listen, we'll have to wait and see what happens later on tonight, everybody. Ulrika Johnson. Coming up, more Ulrika, more ex-housemates, and a little more of Brian Bello, Mario and Glyn than is strictly healthy to see. We will catch you in 3. Welcome back to BBLB. It's day 93. The time is 6:15, and it's finale Friday, everyone. Oh, so good. Right, it is with a heavy heart that we now meet the friends and family of our 5 finalists for a final 3 minutes of humiliation, guys. Please welcome David's auntie, Lindsay, Nazneen, who's Siavash's cousin, Peter, who's Rodrigo's English dad, Chelsea, Sophie's friend, and Andrew, who is Charlie's friend. We can do better on the applause than that, guys. And clap yourselves. And Lindsay, Robbie Williams said on the radio today that he'd already voted for David. Would he be hyped about that?
Well, yeah, he's a big fan, actually, yeah. He'll be over at Moore.
He'll be over
that.
The moon, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, and Nazim, what's going on with your cousin? We've got a day to go. All of a sudden, he starts kicking off about wanting to come out of the house.
I just think he was upset about the whole situation, so he just decided on
what situation, babe? Well, there is no, what, they're not getting much airtime.
I know,
because
it's...
Yes, exactly.
No, I don't think that was it, really. No, I just think the whole Noreen thing really messed up.
Oh, the Noreen thing, yeah, still playing on his mind, I'm sure. And now, Peter, you're Rodrigo's English dad.
I am indeed,
correct.
Yeah.
Now, when we had our queen in, she came out and she absolutely loved him. She sat on the show, she said, we should be so proud of him. Britain as a nation should be so proud of him. Are
absolutely.
You a proud dad?
Absolutely, yes. He was impeccable, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Absolutely brilliant.
No, he seems like a lovely lad.
Great.
OK, now, Chelsea, apart from the obvious, what do you think it is about Sophie that everybody likes so much?
She's just so lovely, genuine, she's so sweet, and I think she just really deserves to win.
Yeah?
By the way.
OK, good friend. Now, Andrew, do you think Charlie ever thought he'd get this far?
No way. I think he expected probably to stay at all somewhere during the middle.
Right, OK. He's looking a bit cocky, though, the last few days to me.
Do you think so?
Yeah, I think so. I think he thinks he's onto something. So, over here, we have 3 Beyoncés, his ex-housemates, Glyn, Brian and Mario, everybody. They are going to be shaking their booties to Single Ladies. Brian won't be... he's hurt his knee, everybody, in a dance-off last night.
Unlucky.
However, he will give it his best shot. Friends and family, you will have to pelt them with your different coloured paint, all right? And we've got our independent adjudicator here, Ulrika, who's going to decide which one of you is the winner. Whoever wins gets to make a plea on behalf of their respective housemate. Do you understand?
Yeah.
All right, can we have the music, please? Are you ready to dance?
Yeah!
All right, let's get some music on. Ulrika, are you ready, my love?
I'm ready.
OK, on your call, darling, on your call.
Ready, steady, go!
Come in here, darling. So who's got the most, which colour can we see the most of, darling? Because that decides who wins.
I'm guessing, there's a lot of black
on there. You've got to make the call.
Okay.
Yellow, red.
Orange.
The orange, you say. The orange, right, okay. I think we're going to say that's you. Nesneen, yeah, that'll do.
No!
Right, that's your camera. You've got 20 seconds to tell us why CFS should be staying. All right, darling, go for it.
I think he's been an amazing housemate. He's got such a great personality. He's been very entertaining. He's done so well so far. Oh, yes, he is. And I think the nation love him, so start voting and make him the winner of BB10.
I think he's been
very entertaining. Everybody loves him. He's got a great personality.
All right, darling, that'll do. Thank you, Ulrika. Thank you very much. Thank you, Beyonce. Girls, you were fantastic. Now let's have a little look at an emotional VT cut to some soft rock, but don't let it influence your vote now, will you?
How do you all feel to be in the final five?
Unless message to Big Brother.
It was sort of like a bam from the moment we came in.
What's your name?
Sobej Siovash.
It's been fun. It's been sad.
I came in the first day and I'm leaving the last day.
I've had loads of fun, you know, like with the different tasks.
Made some amazing friends in here, like, that I really, really like. Will 100% stay in touch from the outside.
I've got a letter from the camera.
Woohoo! You're like a little family and you feel like you're going to get, like, tomorrow, we're going to get separated.
I can't believe this.
Thank you so much!
I had all the feelings you can imagine. I was happy, I was sad, I was angry.
Why did I just go here? Why Rodrigo? Experimental.
I found it be emotional and enjoyable, and I've had so much fun.
Fantastic!
And if I could bottle this and sell it, and I'd make a fortune, I would.
Could you give Big Brother a final message?
We love you.
We love you, Big Brother!
Who wins Big Brother 2009? You decide. Call 09016 1616. For Charlie to win at 04. For David to win at 18. For Rodrigo to win at 11. For Siavash to win at 13. For Sophie to win at 15. Calls cost 35p from a BT landline. Other networks may vary. Mobiles will cost considerably more. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in tonight's live final. Now, this year on BBLB, we are starting a new tradition, slightly undermined by the fact that the show's finishing next year. Anyway, it's called Winner's Day. Here's our winner's tree, everybody. How about that? Under which you've got prizes for your chosen winner. Trust me, you will all be doing it at home. First up, ladies and gentlemen, we have big friend of the show, Mr. David Schneider. Come on out. Come on, Daddy's knee. No. Right, come on now. What present have you got?
Well, I've got for David, who I love. I've got a little Lisa doll.
A little Lisa. Right, okay. So when he's missing her, because wow, she looks lovely. How about that for the likeness, Lisa?
Because
we press it and.
I think you're the great kid.
Is there any more?
I'm going to make a cup of tea when I've done this.
Oh, that's amazing.
Lisa is like his rock. Well, there's so much smoke, it's more volcano, isn't it?
Yeah.
But, you know, I really love David. I hope he wins. He wears his, not just his heart on his sleeve, but his liver and his lungs, which are obviously in a terrible state. He wears everything on his sleeve. So, David, go, David.
Go, David. All right, David, do you want to put that down on the screen? Thank you, David. Say right, next up, who have we got? We've got the beautiful Grace Dent. Come on out, Grace Dent. Come on, Daniel. Come on. Hey, tell me Sit on here, darling. Very good.
Now, oh, my.
What have you got here for us, Grace? What is this?
Oh, it's a present for Rodrigo.
Really?
I love Rodrigo. I absolutely love him. And what it is FIFA 2 at the Ritz.
No way.
Because you know that he loves everything about Britain and being British and everything.
So you thought it would be nice to have a little bit of afternoon tea?
I think so. And also to make up for the mean thing he did to him about the Queen, which was horrible.
No, no, come on, he loved it. He had the time of his life.
I know, but what he needs is he needs to be shown kindness and love, and I'm going to show him that at the Ritz.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but just tea
You haven't
and
got
cakes.
A room there, do you? It's just tea and cakes,
you
yeah?
Never know, you
right,
never
okay,
know.
Grace, then, thank you very much. You want to put that underneath for us, darling?
I will.
Thank you.
Oh.
Very good. Who's up next? Donal, bring in Lee.
Happy Winners Day!
Happy Winners Day, you jump on here, mate.
Okay, George.
Do you want to open that up?
Yeah,
for
I've got
everybody?
A present for him, David. Yeah. I know he doesn't like any nonsense, so I've got him a leather bound copy of the Big Brother
David's
rules.
He's getting a lot of presents. He loves the rules, doesn't he?
He loves the rules, so he can sit there by the fire with a smoking jacket, having a little read of the rules over Christmas.
He feels a little bit wrong about this, I don't know why.
It feels, do you know what? Nothing's ever felt this right to me, and I don't want it to end ever.
Do you think he's going to prefer Lisa's the Lisa doll from David? Or
yeah,
or
no,
the big
no he'll prefer that. But David has to win. It's like, you know when you saw him blubbing when he found out it was going to be in the final? Yeah. Can you imagine what it'd be like tonight if he wins? It'd be like...
Forget it.
It'd be like he's won Miss World and he's clutching a bouquet of flowers, just blubbing. So he must win.
Yes, OK.
OK.
Do you want to put that under the tree,
I'd
my love?
To.
Thank you, very good. Next up, come on in. Come on in. Who's the next friend of the show? It's only Mike Hall. Mike Hawk, now this is definitely very weird. Mike Hawk sitting on my knee. Right, what have we got, sir? What's in here?
Dear St. George, sitting this close to you, I feel like I ought to be doing some neck snapping.
Right, okay.
All right, what I got here, my little gifty, is a mighty fine pair of butt-kicking boots.
For Sophie?
Yes,
to kick Chris's butt?
That's right.
No way!
In case she needs some butt-talk to boot.
Look, they're on steel toe cap. Chris, are you feeling nervous, mate?
You should.
You should be. You should be. Mike's going to come after you with these. Mike, do you want to put them under the tree?
Roger that.
Thank you. Roger that. Exactly. Very good. And we've got one last friend to tell everybody. It's only Ravi. Oh, come on, Ravi. Sit yourself down on my knee, my dear.
Hello, Father Christmas.
Hello. You're right.
I'm okay.
Of course, Ravi would bring two gifts, wouldn't he, eh? Let's have a look at what you've got.
Start
What's the
with
first
this one.
Yeah.
Now, this is for Siavash.
Yeah. And you want Siavash to win, do you?
Well, yeah, kind of. And he's a really hairy guy.
OK.
But I don't think we've seen the man behind the hair.
Right.
And so with a view to that...
A grooming... Oh, it's only a
you
grooming
got it.
Kit. What an incredibly friendly man, eh? Freddie, are you happy that old Ravi's rooting for Siavash?
That's great, yeah.
He's generally happy about everything, old Freddie. Right, OK, what have we got over
This next one is for Charlie.
Yeah.
And we all know the situation in the house with Rodrigo, so I thought this would be the most fitting gift ever for him.
Oh, eh? Look at that. I love Rod. What a beautiful
Isn't that
thing.
Awesome?
Did you make this?
I did myself. It took me about...
7 whole hours. What a lovely friend you are. Who do you prefer to win out of the two of them?
I think probably Siavash.
Really? Siavash to win for you, yeah?
Yeah, pretty much.
All right, my love, do you want to put the gifts underneath the tree?
They're all winners.
Hey, they are all winners, Lee. You're so right about that. Give them a big round of applause, everybody. So, coming up, Wolfman meets Wolfman, and we'll all get a long, lingering look at the Vena's best bit. So, hey! This is great. The party's in full swing at 6:30 and it's finale Friday, everyone. Oh, right, here we go. We have our ex-housemates hanging out in the VIP all evening. Isn't that right, guys, hey? Yes. Shree, you're not wearing your best jumper. What the hell's going on?
I already wear it in the house, though, so...
Right, you've worn it already. Is it still your favourite jumper or not really?
It is indeed.
Right, OK, nice to see you, Shree. Penny. What are you doing in here?
I broke in, mate.
Through the back door. Right, OK. Who are you going to be voting for tonight?
Sophie and Siavash.
Yeah? Sophie and Siavash.
Love them.
We'll let me see how they get on. Hera, could you do us a favour?
Sure.
Could you sing for us? Could you sing who you want to win? She jumped the gun a little bit there, didn't she?
Would love to.
Go
are
on,
you
then.
Sure? Are
yeah.
you sure?
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Who do you want to win tonight, darling?
Rodrigo or Sophie.
Rodrigo or Sophie, yeah, OK. Angel, how are you, my love?
Great, thank you very much.
How are the preparations for the Eurovision going?
Great, I'm taking singing lessons from here. Yeah, she's doing well.
You want to be careful about that. You want to be careful. Are you still looking for Eurovision?
Thank you very much. Yeah, I'm preparing, yes, thank you.
Yeah, OK, well, you know, we've got the petition going, don't
yes,
you?
Yes, yes.
Do you know how many people have signed it yet?
Yes, it's about 1,500.
Really, it's pretty good. Make sure you sign the petition, guys. Now, Kyron, how you doing, mate? Long time no see.
Yes, sir. Yes, it is.
You and Sivash got very friendly in the house, didn't you? I can't get out of the way. You and Sivash were very friendly, weren't you? Huh?
Yeah, we was.
Are you going to be hanging out when he gets out?
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
Do you still want him to win, do you think?
Always.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Right, OK. Why do you think he wanted to walk? What do you think that was all about?
Maybe, I don't know, maybe he got sick of it.
Yeah, but what, a day before the end?
Yeah, well, we never
know. You don't
know.
Think he was looking? We will know when he gets out on Sunday. Absolutely. I'm going to ask him. Don't worry about that. Lisa, how are you doing, darling?
All right,
big
thank
party
you.
Tonight, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, fantastic.
I don't see any tea here. What's going on? You're going for the stronger stuff?
Yeah, something stronger tonight, definitely.
Were you ever tempted to walk whilst you were in the house, Lisa?
No.
Really?
I was always going out that door, out the front.
Right, OK, you're going out the front door, not the back door like that's Benazir. Right. What a nightmare there. Hey, Marcus, how are you, mate?
Never better.
Who do you think is going to be Captain Cool tonight?
Me.
Right, OK.
Every night.
Every night, that's what I do, that's who I am. Who's going to be Captain Cool number two, then?
I'll go with Roddy.
Roddy, yeah, you reckon?
Yeah,
you reckon? A lot of people are asking if you had a little trim, Marcus.
Yeah, a little trim. My mate Roger, again.
Yeah, what, Roger
Jeffrey's
came
in Brentford,
on the show?
Yeah, he was here earlier on. Nice.
Looking for a free haircut, you say, Marcus?
I had to pay for this today. Hey, they made me pay.
You're kidding me.
Swine.
You're a bitching night haircut. Of all the press we've given him, do you know what I mean? How dare he? How dare he? Now, I believe you met our real-life Wolfman, didn't you?
Yes, indeed, he met me.
And he met me. I love how you turn around. And you put your Wolfman credentials to the test. You
indeed.
Went down and you live with the wolves.
Yes, got amongst it.
Shall we have a little look, guys? Yeah. Come on then, let's have a look and see how you got on.
Hi, Marcus. How are you? How's welcome you going, to Coomartin Wildlife Park.
Great to be here.
Do you like wolves?
Yeah, I wanted to have one as a kid. Take it around, make it eat people.
Yes. First thing we're going to do is a locating howl to let them know that we're here. Well done, mate.
I heard that.
So what we're picking up now is all the different ranks make a different sound. So I've got my family telling me where to come, I've got all the rival packs telling me where not to come. Okay, so you're probably wondering what all that was about. What you have to try and mimic is that kind of and then it goes to a kind of a good, well done. That's good, well done. That lower yourself a bit, lower. That's it. Good, just move it back now. That's good, well done. I think we understand each other. Got a bit of mutual respect going, so it's not going to be fisticuffs just yet.
Looks like these boys are ready to tuck in. Let's let them get amongst it. Definitely some element of food banditry going on down there. Those wolves annihilated that food in a greater fashion than even what Lisa and David did to the butter that day. Well, it's getting to the end of my time here today and it's been absolutely brilliant. It's the first time in a long time that I haven't been on one of these shows where you haven't made me look like a complete and total tool. So, thanks for that.
Please welcome Sean and his wolves, Diva and Karlik, everybody. Now, I've got to be totally honest with you. Off the back of what happened last time with the tiny ones, I am pretty para. Right, how are we doing, guys? We all right?
Yeah, we're good, mate.
Are they in good shape?
Yeah, they're all right.
Everything's going to be all right. I'm going to sit over here. Everything's going to be fine. Were you impressed with Marcus when he came down?
Yeah, he was good, actually. He showed all the balance and qualities that we'd look for. Yeah,
you look pretty comfortable over there.
Yeah, they're all right.
Yeah, the last time I did that, one of them nearly took my arm off.
Can I say, judge a character?
Looking at me funny, I think. So Marcus, would you have preferred to live with a bunch of wolves for 12 weeks, or were you happy living with that bunch over there?
Well, these lot definitely have better table manners.
Really?
And a lot more respect, so I'll pick these lot any day.
How dare he, huh? Can you believe it, guys? Now, Sean, is it true you're going off to Australia to teach Hugh Jackman how to be more wolf-like before the
could
new
be,
wolf?
Could be, yeah. They've actually asked us if we would consider maybe doing some advisory work because he's portraying a wolf, which is fantastic for us. Because they've always been portrayed as the demons with the full moon in the background.
Yeah.
So it'd be great to go over there and teach them a little bit about what we taught Marcus, really.
How amazing is that, everybody, eh? Going over to teach Hugh Jackman about it. And I believe you're going on Oprah as well.
Yep, there's a possibility of that. For the second or third week in October, we're probably going to go out and do a tour for the book, launch of the new book.
Yeah.
And hopefully, yeah, that's one of them.
Yeah, I think Big Brother's Little Brother's got to take a little bit of credit for that, you know what I mean? Just, you know, we're introducing Sean to the media world. Let's clap Big Brother's Little Brother, everybody. Now, Sean, can you teach Marcus how to do maybe one of the calls, one of the wolf calls, yeah?
Yeah, well, what we've got here, we've got a lovely-looking young female, and because Marcus is a bit of a ladies' man, we
yes.
thought the connection could come in quite nicely. So what we're going to do, we're going to teach him how to woo a wolf.
Yeah.
If that makes sense, OK? So the first thing he has to do, the call that he did on the day that he came down was a completely different one. It's what we call a locating howl. This one is going to be a call from across the valley. He'd be locating his female. She'd be calling back to him. So it's
yeah.
going to
sound you do that a lot, Marcus?
Yeah.
I like down that. There in Brentford on a Saturday night, you know what I mean? Just hanging out the window. Mum's out for the evening. Oh,
that's it.
Calling them on,
got
yeah.
Me sussed.
Okay. No, okay. I've heard it. I've seen it down here, yeah.
So we've got the basics, okay? So what we're going to do is give you a different thing to say.
Okay.
So let's try this one. Okay. If you listen and then you can mimic.
What are we looking for in the wolf? What should the wolf be doing?
In here, probably nothing.
Right, okay.
To be honest with you. But you never know. You know, there might be a bit of lipstick going on, a bit of perfume behind the ears. You never
yeah.
know.
It's really nice. Look at the claws. Well, I think she's in love. Oh, look. She wants a piece. She wants. Oh, hello. Right, okay, Marcus, it's your turn. Careful. I can't believe you got blank like that, Marcus. Do you want to have another blast?
No, no,
come
she's
on.
All right.
Nightmare. Didn't work on the wolf. What about Noreen? Did that work for you, babe? Did that stir any of the old passions, girl?
No, it's a no for me. Didn't work for me, thank you.
Just good friends still?
Just friends.
Oh, not that again. All right, well, listen, it was more interesting than the food. Sean and Marcus, everybody, give them a big round of applause. Diva and Carly. Now, the party isn't over yet. Coming up, David Schneider takes our competition winner down a dark passage and we meet Davina on the live set. We'll see you in four. Welcome back to BBLB and our pre-show party is still in full swing, isn't it, guys, eh? Yeah. Now, one man having the time of his life today is our Big Brother winner, Jobby, who is in the heart of the action with our camera runs connoisseur, Mr. David Schneider. Jobby, congrats on winning the competition. What's it like being in there so close to the house, mate?
It's absolutely unreal, George. I've got to talk quietly, but there's so much going on.
It's a it's a wonderful time to come.
It is.
The adrenaline is pumping there.
What can you see in there?
Well, Dave actually wriggled one of his toes about half.
No way.
It was quite exciting.
He's opened his eyes. He's opened his eyes.
What's getting handed over there? Is that pictures?
I think it could be.
It
pictures
looks like
of Lisa, I'm sure. Or various cigarettes, different cigarettes at different points of smoking. you really get a sense here that the final is upon us. There's frenzy, there's adrenaline, it's pumping. And I'll tell you, if the final's going to be anything as exciting as what we're seeing now, then
it's
we're in
be
trouble.
Pretty scintillating stuff. Do they look like they're getting ready at all? I don't see much preparation going
on. Nothing. No, apparently Sophie is having a shower, and Siavash has decided that if he does win, he's never leaving the house. That's only right.
Really?
That's what
he's decided. Is that what they're saying right now? David, how does it feel being in a confined space with Jobby in the dark?
I
hey, Dave.
I'm slightly nervous. I'm slightly nervous, I have to say, but can you see?
it's exciting, though, isn't it, Dave? It's exciting.
Well, see, I don't know what's going on there. They've all got a little bit excited. Things are falling all to pieces.
Yeah, my headphones fell off. It's just the potential of Jobby's magnetism. Yeah. It's just the word Jobby. It's for me. It's what I had a Scottish.
I must point out that I'm not called that because of the Scottish. Referral.
It's Scottish for poo.
It is indeed.
All right, boys, listen, don't worry about all that.
Yeah, sorry.
Have a nice time over there. We'll see you in a bit, all
okay,
right?
Cheers.
Nice one, Jobby. He's going to be meeting Davin a little bit later on. Let's have a look at Jobby's journey so far on BBLB. Jobby,
are you excited about the potential of becoming Big Brother?
I really am. Spent most of my life wanting to do this.
We've got a winner. It's Jobby, everybody. Oh, pretty powerful stuff there. Time now to talk to the beating heart, the very essence, the ether, if you will, of Big Brother. It's only Davina, everybody.
Is that me?
That is you, man. How are you? All right, you good?
Hi.
Final night.
You're
I can't
so
believe it, can you?
I know, it's kind of...
We're here.
Yeah, it's
again.
Weird.
Again. It's crazy. It's do you get weird. Nervous or do you get excited?
Well, at the moment, my head's just one big tumble dryer of information. So at the moment, I'm
what
all
an,
I'm
what
doing
an amazing analogy.
Is processing.
What an amazing white goods analogy. I love that.
Do you love it?
What kind of information's in the tumble dryer?
Well, just
right
go
now,
over here, stand spin. Over there, then go over there, and then don't forget when it's in the break, you mustn't.
Don't fall off the side.
So,
do you ever get scared you might make the wrong announcement?
Or yes. Yes. No. And the worst crime to reality television is the wrong telephone number.
Right. Okay.
You know, I'm you're so, why am right I talking to this?
I don't know that you've got a little.
What am
knife,
I doing?
Is there ever a little bit of you? Because I know there would be if it were me that would say the wrong that just say the wrong number. Kidding.
No.
No.
I would lose my job.
Really? Do you reckon
year,
you would?
Exactly.
You're going to lose it next year anyway.
Yeah,
does it matter?
I'll do it next year.
What's been your highlight of this series?
You.
Yes, you're right. Yeah. You're right. Yeah, me too, actually. That's
I did
weird.
Love the Queen.
Yeah, no, wasn't she lovely?
She was fantastic. And I thought the whole him getting to meet the Queen, being an ardent royalist myself, knowing that, you know, thinking that was so cute, and him totally going for it.
He was so cool about it when he got revealed.
And, you know, he's normally chucks such a strop.
Such a hissy, And he
didn't. I love that.
I've been having loads of people telling me, you know what, I think this is the best year ever on Big Brother. And I'm wondering, obviously, next year's going to be a super important year because you're going to be the last year on Channel 4. But, I mean, what can they do to top it, really?
You know, it's all about the housemates, and I don't know... When you're casting people, I'm sure they cast Rodrigo thinking he was one thing, but you know they'd never seen Rodrigo having a hissy fit, and you know they hadn't seen Siavash just getting off. You know you can't
so it's,
foresee.
It's down to the it's casting. Down,
it's all about the casting.
All about the casting.
And watching them unfold and all go like on tangents.
Well,
I'll
tell you what, Davina, you've watched a lot of them unfold over the last 10 years. You've been a truly amazing host, and we've got your best bits now. And have a look at this.
Welcome to Big Brother.
Don't panic. This is Davina. You are live on Channel 4. Please do not swear.
Let's kick another one out.
Remember, I told you.
One in, one out tonight.
Only two games! Did you have sexual relations?
No, we didn't.
Oh, more there!
Do you want to go back into the house? Hell yeah. Follow me.
Whatever. The house is full to bursting.
Welcome back to Big Brother.
Do you fancy knocking one out? It's duck in there.
Oh, what a beautiful thing, eh? How do you feel watching all that?
Oh,
It's
been great.
It has been. It's not over yet. Don't worry about it. How on earth can we top that?
For God's sakes, don't do that for me next year, because I'll be
You'll be sobbing on the floor. I'll have to pick you off the floor. I'm thinking the only thing maybe that can top this is getting Jobby out. He sucked maggots and jumped in a skip and brushed his teeth with fish guts just to be here. We have got a VT of his highlights. Come on in, actually, Jobby. Come on in. Come and say hello.
Nice to meet you.
Have you met already or not?
That's nice. I haven't, no.
This is it. That was the first meeting you just bought. That was history. Just happened there, guys.
What a man!
That was your prize, Jobby.
I'm a made man.
You're a made man.
You can die very happy now. We've got a VT of the highlights of Jobby's day as Big Brother. Have a little look at this. It's a beautiful day.
Come on, yes! I'm the winner.
This is Big Brother. Would Charlie come to the diary room?
Ooh! Sounds lovely.
Hello, Charlie.
Yeah, really?
How are you today?
I'm absolutely spot on.
This is Big Brother.
Go on, Roddy.
Would Rodrigo come to the diary room?
He's got the best looking for the vice, man.
Hello, Rodrigo.
Hello, Big Brother.
How are you today?
I'm very well.
If you were to win, what would you use the prize money for?
If I was to win, I'd give some prize money. I'd probably pin my ears back because, as you can you see that? They really do stick out.
What are you most looking forward to about leaving the Big Brother house?
Obviously, I'm going to Vivian Westwood. Obviously, wants to meet me, so that's what I'm probably most looking forward to now.
Thank you, Siavash. You may now leave the diary room.
Thank you, sir. It's been a pleasure. I never spoke to you before. You sound very excited.
Thank you, Rodrigo. You may now leave the diary room.
Thank you very much, Big Brother. It was really nice talking to you, and thank you very much for coming to the house today to visit us. Bye.
Now, Jobby, I don't know if you know this, but they were all asked what they thought of your Big Brother voice, and they loved it.
Did they?
All of them, unanimously.
Fantastic.
How about that?
That was brilliant. It was just overwhelming experience, you know, to be there.
It's a little bit jealous, Davina, of him being able to be
a little
Big Brother.
But I love the kind of booming side to the voice, the projection. Yes. It's amazing.
The northern part of it.
It's amazing.
Real good. All right, well, listen, Jobby, I hope you enjoyed claiming your prize.
I have.
Jobby and Davina, everybody. Davina, you have fun tonight, babe. You have fun. Now, we have five finalists, but who wins? Who wins?
Come on, George.
You decide!
Here are the numbers to call.
Who wins Big Brother 2009? You decide. Call 09016 1616. For Charlie to win at 04. For David to win at 18. For Rodrigo to win at 11. For Siavash to win at 13. For Sophie to win at 15. Calls cost 35p from a BT landline. Other networks may vary. Mobiles will cost considerably more. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in tonight's live final.
Nice one. Nicely done. So our ex-housemates are still hanging in the VIP lounge. Looks like a crisp advert over here with all these walkers, eh? Look at that, eh? Come on, who's better than that? Other crisps are available, everybody. How we do it? Unfortunately, Isaac couldn't be with us. Real shame, that. Nay, what a shame. What a lovely guy. Any regrets about walking, my dear?
I think I set a bit of a trend off, really. I would have liked to have stayed maybe on the Friday just to have seen a certain person go, but apart from that,
Let it go still, my love. Come on. You didn't last very long, Tommy.
No regrets, George, no regrets.
Really?
Bit of fun, short and sweet.
And what about you, Kenny? I'll come round here. What about you, my man? Were you happy? Is it all gone well? Have you had a nice summer? Have you been hanging out, doing nice things?
Yeah, all's cool. No regrets about leaving. Let's meet get closer to my fans on Twitter.
What's that?
Let's me get closer to my fans on Twitter.
Right, you've got Twitter fans, do you?
One or two.
Now, you were good friends with Sophie, Carly.
Yes.
Are you hoping that she wins?
Oh, all day long. Come on, the girls,
Do you think it's likely, though?
Definitely. She's won already.
Am I right in saying that you put a £10,000 bet on her?
Yeah, I have so much faith in her, and
I
really hope she wins.
£10,000? What odds did you get?
5-1.
Really? So 50 grand in the bin? How about that? I'm assuming that's Kenny's, though, you've put on there.
Yeah.
Good girl. It's a win-win then, you know what I mean? If you lose, it doesn't matter, does it? Right. Now, Noreen, what am I going to ask you? What about Sivash? Would he get your vote?
No, the only person I'm going to vote for is Charlie.
Really? Yeah. But even after you had your little, you know, thing with him, you don't feel that you owe it to him a little bit after you darked him out so hard?
No, he's a nice guy, but I really want Charlie to win because he's a great guy.
Really? Right, OK. Now, Chrissy, obviously.
Yes,
Sophie might come out and she might be the victor. And then what's going to happen? Are you going to chase after or not, or what?
We have to wait and see, won't we? Have to tune in.
Oh, it's all you ever see is you have to wait to see. Come
you
on.
You have to wait and see.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'm not lining myself up for a fall again. I've done it once, right, and I'm okay. Not doing it again.
But will you put out the olive branch?
The what?
The olive branch. What's the peat, you know, like, to make a
oh,
kind
yeah,
of peace
yeah,
with
build
that.
Some bridges, yeah, I'll do that, yeah.
Yes, OK, good. OK, best, yeah. bridge building. Oh, sorry. We've all had a drink. I'm sorry about that. Yeah, Freddie, who gets your vote, mate?
Sivash gets two votes, and Roddy and Sophie get one each from me.
Really?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, OK, well, we'll have to wait and see what happens. What about you? But thank you, my love. Thank you for looking after me. Who do you want to win, darling?
Charlie.
What are you booing at? What's wrong with you guys? Come on, it's over.
What's
it's done. The dream's
it's
over.
It's a game, yeah, guys.
It's a game.
Get
exactly.
over it.
Exactly.
Or go home.
Who do you want to see?
Charlie.
Still got the tongue. Still got the scathing tongue. Charlie wants to win it. And what about you, Princess?
It has to be either Rodrigo, Sivash or Sophie.
So everybody pretty much in. All right, well, listen.
And Dave,
thank you very much, everybody. You've all been fantastic. That is it for tonight's finale show. A big thank you to all my guests. Don't forget to join us on Sunday on T4 at 12 p.m. for a very special reunion show with all our housemates and the winner of Big Brother 2009. Make sure you watch the Coronation Channel 4 tonight at 8:30. Take care. Bye-bye.